So it looks like Nintendo's a lot of their source code got hacked recently, and it makes me want to talk about that stuff. Hello everybody, Xeno here, and I hope you guys are feeling comfortable and warm because I'm not. It feels like 40 degrees in here, but oh well. You guys can't feel it, so I don't even know why I'm talking about it. But what I should be talking about is the weird, and I call it weird because it's like Nintendo's security is usually pretty high, but the fact that somebody was able to get tons and tons of source code from N64, GameCube, I think even the Wii era for a lot of their games is astonishing. And now they can be publicly seen. People are already jumping on porting the games over, like completely, to PC, and it is freaking insane. And with all that stuff, especially when you already see footage of like Mario 64 running at 4, 8K. And they're even trying to get 60 FPS working or even higher. They're working on it right now, but even seeing that already with how little time has been worked on for these leaked source code files, it only makes me think of why the heck did Nintendo not do this for their ports for the past few decades? Because what they usually end up doing is setting up an emulator for like Virtual Console, for example, and emulate the games. It now baffles my mind to think that they did something like this because they could have easily ported the game over to the new architecture. I don't know how hard it would be to do it, but apparently it shouldn't be that hard if we already have hackers. I hate using that word because they're people who acquired the source code. You know, someone else got the source code, other people are using the code to make their own PC ports of these games. And they did it in little to no time at all. And the fact that they're not doing that for current games or re-releasing them in this method, it baffles me because I feel like you could further utilize the architecture of the graphics and the CPU to help run the game even smoother. Like even smoother. If I throw footage of supposed 4K gameplay, actually I think this one is 8K. They took the 4K video down. This guy's using a 1080. He's running it at 8K and it's only using like 15 to 20% of his GPU while playing the game. Now, if you were to emulate it at 8K, it would actually have to be recompiled on the fly to pretend it's a N64 to run its code and then re-upscale the graphics afterward, which takes a lot of processing. And as a further result, one, you are getting, I guess, close to accurate emulation, but if you're porting the game over, you're already getting one-to-one code of what's being executed anyway. But two, it takes a lot more power to make that happen on the fly. So I don't know why Nintendo isn't doing that, didn't do this for the Wii U era or for the Virtual Console era, because it would have helped make run games even smoother. Heck, they could even fix the code, re-release the game with better support. Like imagine, since the Wii U has so much, you know, like literally hundreds of times the power of an N Nintendo 64, you could have Mario 64 running with its native graphics to keep it that flair and style, but they could have fixed the engine where you could have run it at 60 FPS because they've had the source code for years and years and years. The only reason why I feel like they decided to release the source code reported over as an emulator, you know, fake emulator, it's just re-releasing the game for a newer console, is because other third-party games wouldn't be as compatible. Other companies have their source code not available. It wouldn't be so easy to port those over at the same time for the Virtual Console. Whereas if Nintendo just made an emulator, they could have just used a baseline. I don't know how emulators are made, so I apologize if this sounds really stupid, but they just make a baseline emulator that is good enough at executing tons and tons of different kinds of code from different games that just run right out of the bat. So they can easily just take a ROM, dump it in the emulator, sell it for $6.99, and call it a day. Sometimes running it at upscaled resolution and secretly, if they do that, they won't tell you, but I have a feeling that's why they stuck with emulators for so long. But the fact of the matter is they have source code to so many games and they still have them. And thank God that to a certain, I mean, I do feel bad for Nintendo for them losing their source code files to a security flaw. But thank God we got it, because now if it ever gets lost, it's out on the internet where it'll never be truly lost, because people will download it, people will copy it, tons and tons of people will keep messing with it. So it'll never be truly lost. We've had other games like Kingdom Hearts, where they've lost the source code to the original game for the PS2 completely, and they had to re-release it. They had to remake it from the ground up for the PS3 so they could remake it. Now, again, they just took the ROM and the assets and helped speed up the development, but they had to redo the engine from scratch. Now, it helped make it run better on the PS3, but they still were limited to making it like 30 FPS and other stuff like that. But the fact of the matter is, they still have the source code, and they didn't re-release it. It just makes me more mad at Nintendo because they've had the ability to do this for years, and I can't believe I never really thought about that they've had the ability to do this for years, and they never did anything about it because they should start doing stuff like that, right? Especially right now, if they lost all their code, lost, it is out in the public. They should be doing this so people who still want to support their company get the ports they deserve instead of having to pirate. Pirate's another loose term. The game on PC, because it's out there. I haven't acquired it yet. I would love to acquire it because Mario 64 at 8K running native code on my PC. Sign me up. That's one of the best games ever made, in my opinion. So I don't know what else to say. I'm just baffled at Nintendo. Not happy we got these codes, but I still feel bad for them. But they're a corporation. Feelings are all over the place. But I don't know. I just wanted to see what your guys' opinion was, because that's my opinion. I don't know why they didn't re-release this with native code, like port it over. It hurts my brain. But whatever. I just want to see what you guys think. So tell me what you say down in the comments below, and hopefully I'll get to other kinds of content soon because I've been a lazy little son of a bee. So see you guys later. Xeno's out here.